Now let's learn this architecture, which is data-centric architecture. Data-centric architecture is an architectural approach that prioritizes data management and organization as the core aspect of the system. So data is the main focus. In this architecture, the data is central to the application's design, driving the way that components interact and operate. Let's see this with some example. So, okay, Netflix is popular. How Netflix uses data-centric approach, data-centric architecture? Netflix utilizes a centralized data platform that stores vast amount of user data, including viewing habits, preferences, ratings. This data is crucial for understanding user behavior and tailoring content recommendations. Right? So, we watch this movie next time. Netflix will recommend, okay, you have watched this earlier, based on that these are more titles that you can consider. So when a user logs in into Netflix, the platform immediately uses the centralized data to provide personalized recommendations based on the viewing history, ratings and preferences. This data centric approach not only improves user satisfaction but also drives engagement and retention. And by leveraging this architecture, Netflix effectively manages vast amount of data to create a personalized data and seamless streaming experience for users. Let's see the key characteristics of this architecture. Centralized data management. The architecture focuses on a central repository where data is stored, accessed and managed. This can be a database, data warehouse or another form of data store. Data as a first-class citizen. In data-centric architecture, data is treated as primary entity. Business logic and functionality are designed around data management, retrieval and manipulation. Loose coupling. Components of the system are loosely coupled, means they do not rely on each other, meaning that changes to one component, for example data model, right, have minimal impact on others. This enhances maintainability and flexibility. The architecture emphasizes how data flows through the system, focusing on data processing pipelines, transformation and storage rather than on individual components. And then abstraction layers often includes layers of abstractions that separate data access, processing and presentation, allowing for easier changes and upgrades to individual layers without affecting the entire system. So in nutshell, what we have just talked about, this data-centric approach is nothing but, consider there is a data repository which is centralized, and all the software, whether those are clients or functionalities, they are getting the information from this common repository. The main focus is here on the data center with the repository where the data is stored. Right. So, for example, in Netflix example, the data is stored, the user rating, preferences, etc., and whatever information we need. So, for example, fetch ratings. Fetching rating is one of the function. Fetching user preferences and other functions. But all in all, that data is stored in one repository. Let's see the benefits of this architecture. Enhanced data management. Centralizing data makes it easier to enforce data governance, consistency and integrity. Scalability. The architecture can be scaled by enhancing the data storage or processing capabilities independently of the application logic. Of course, because the data is already centralized, so if you want to scale it, we just need to add more resources to the same database. Improved performance. Optimizing data access and management can lead to improved overall application performance because all applications are accessing the same database. So if we are increasing the or optimizing it in terms of scaling or adding more resources to it, since that is the only resource, the repository which is holding all the data, so of course the performance will increase. Simplified development. Developers can focus on data related concerns, which can simplify the design and implementation process. Let's see the use case of this type of architecture. Data warehousing. Systems designed for data analysis and reporting often use data-centric architecture to manage large volume of data efficiently. Business intelligence applications, or sometimes we call it as BI applications, right? Applications that require extensive data manipulation and reporting leverage data-centric design to provide insights from data. So what we do first, we ingest the data into some warehouse, right? And then we have analytics tools. So for example, Power BI or any analytics tool. With that huge data, we do the analysis of that data. So that is also a good use case. Then we have CMS, content management system. CMS platforms often prioritize data storage and retrieval structure, the application around how content is managed and accessed. So we can have a repository within content, within a CMS, right? There we can have centralized data. So for example, within Adobe Experience Manager is one of the CMS which uses JCR to store the data, right? That is also use case. So data-centric architecture is an effective approach for applications that require robust data management and organization, providing clear focus on data as the core element driving application functionality.